So how can we tell if a game is actually engaging? Well, we can usually look at how popular the game is by finding out if the game is downloaded a lot and if the reviews are good. For example, here we can see game apps in the Amazon App Store. And we can see the number of reviews and the star rating from 1 to 5 stars. And this gives us a good idea of how engaging our game is. If the game has a rating close to 5 stars, it's probably pretty fun. And if it's lower, then maybe there's something the users don't like about it. We can also look at how long and how often players use our game and measure engagement. Here are some terms we use to measure it: session count, session length, and retention. Session count is the number of times an app is launched. So any time a player opens the app, whether that's once a week or 10 times a day, the session count goes up. And if we look at the average session counts for a player over a day, we can get a pretty good idea of how addicting our game is. But some games are designed for longer sessions instead of multiple short sessions, so the session length is also important. Session length is the amount of time that the app is in use for a particular session. So whether that's a few minutes or going on and on to lengths of hours. And again, for this to be a useful metric, we would usually look at the average session length across users to see how long a typical user plays once they open the app. And we also look at retention, which is a measure of how many users continue to play your game as time goes on. Usually, game retention is measured a day after your game is first launched and downloaded, a week after, and a month after, just to see how many of your original players you keep over time. Say you want to measure retention over a week for the game Fruit Ninja. That means you want to see how many people who started at the beginning of the week are still around at the end of the week. During the week, some of these early users will leave Fruit Ninja and new ones will join, but we don't want to take into account the new ones. We just want to see who started at the beginning of the week and stayed throughout the whole week. To calculate this, you need to look at the users at the end of the week minus any of the newcomers who joined in the middle of the week, all divided by the number of users that started at the beginning of the week. Then multiply all this by 100 to get a percentage, and this is going to be your retention for the week. So let's look at some numbers for Fruit Ninja. Let's say we had 400 people download the game at the start of the week, and there's 700 total by the end of the week. That looks pretty good. But we also know that 500 of these people are new. They joined in the middle of the week, and they aren't part of our 400 original starting players. So let's calculate the retention. First, we have 700 from the end of the week, minus the 500 new players that joined midweek, so we're only accounting for our original 400 to see who stuck around, all divided by our 400 original players, then times 100 to get a percentage. This is going to be 200 over 400, or half, times 100%, which is going to give us 50% retention over this week, which is pretty good. Ideally, we'd want 100% retention, which means everyone who downloads your game keeps playing it and never quits. But no game has perfect retention, and even really great games have around 50% retention after just the first day. That means that half the players leave during the first 24 hours of playing. This seems like a lot of people leaving, but it's considered pretty good retention, especially if your game is good at getting new players over time. It won't matter that a lot of older ones leave. Lots of developers use a 40-20-10 rule as a guideline for good retention over a day, a week, and a month. So after a game is downloaded by a bunch of people, we have 100% of people, 40% of those users stick around after the first day. 20% of those stay for a week, and only 10% stay for a whole month, and even longer usually. If you have retention at these time points, a day, a week, or a month, that's higher, that's great. If it's any lower, that's considered bad retention.